That is a real story. My friends, mga kasama, public officials are often the targets of criticism by journalists, by people in media. While many criticisms are legitimate, some are baseless, some are malicious, and used merely to insult the person or the public official concerned. The intent of the authors of the Right to Reply Bill is intent naman to ensure balanced reports and responsible journalism. These bills on the right to reply are meant to complement the moves, sana, to decriminalize libel. The rationale behind the right to reply may be sound, but the provisions and the reasons, I do not think, should be upheld. And I am one of those who came out very early in the game against the right to reply for the following reasons. First, the right to reply bill is plain censorship. It violates the freedom of the press by officially hijacking the airtime, the space, intent for the offended party to hit back. Non-compliance of the provisions will subject the editor-in-chief, the publisher, the station manager, or the owner of the broadcast medium to fines and even imprisonment. Alam niyo mga kasama, the essence of free speech, the essence of a free media is control. Who controls what is printed in the newspaper? Who controls what is said in the airwaves over the radio? Who controls what is shown in television? And that is where the right of reply bill fails constitutionally, sapagkat tinatanggal yung control. Tinatanggal yung control sa press at binibigyan.